Hey, this is Ralph, and in this video, I want to use Excel 365 to make some pie charts out of student loan data. Now, I got this data off the web, off of a government website, and there'll be a link in the description where you can grab this data too. I did make a couple conversions to it. It was already in billions and millions, so it had reduced values there, and I put those into the full amounts, estimated, of course, or rounded anyway. And what I want to focus on first is a pie chart. Now, in Excel 365, we really need to have our pie chart data all in contiguous cells. They need to be chunked together. If this was Excel 2019 or even older versions of installed Excel, we could work with that. We could select non-contiguous ranges. So I'm going to need to move some data over into a slightly better grouping. Good news is when you're making pie charts, simple is always better. For instance, on this particular worksheet, here's a pie chart, and although there's quite a few data values, it's usually pretty simple to look at. I wouldn't want to do really many more than these, but pie charts are good for showing parts of a whole. In fact, I think they have a simpler looking pie chart here too. Yeah, so in this pie chart, there was a few wedges, and the wedges were big enough, the portions were big enough, that they could put data values right inside of the pie chart. So we can give something like that a try too. But on my data, let's go ahead and clean up and group together some of this. And I think my first pie chart is going to be to take the age categories of student loan borrowers and compare that to the totals. So I'm going to just pick on this cell right here, and I'll say equals B1. It wants to make a little function there. Equals D1. There we go. So now I've got my data grouped nicely. So to make my pie chart, I'm going to select that chunk of data, head over to my insert ribbon, look over at my chart choices. There's a drop down so I can see all of the various charts on here, but I'm going to go ahead and create a pie chart. There's the default pie chart. Let me go ahead and maximize that for a bit, make it a little larger anyway so we can see that more clearly. Great. And there's our standard pie chart. However, it's always going to need a little bit of formatting, I think. So let's start from the top here. We got our chart title. So the chart title is set. It looks like it's set to above chart, which is where it looks like it's displayed. But I can go to chart title, edit my chart title, and it looks like I've got here student loan dollars outstanding by age group. Okay, that's pretty good. Now for my other fixes, I have some choices. I'm currently in the chart ribbon, I'm in editing mode, and I've got some tools right up here at the top where I can manipulate things, but I can also display a formatting pane off to the side. That's going to come in handy. For instance, I'm going to click on that formatting pane, and I'm going to look at my legend choices. I see currently my legend is set to a 9-point font. That's pretty small. And if I'm going to use a legend, I want to make sure everything's big and chunky and easy to read. I'm going to blow that up to like an 18-point font. That looks pretty good. And of course, I could change the position of that legend. I'll put it over on the left so it sticks over there. All right, that makes it a little bit easier to read. We can do some other things too, though. For instance, I can go to data labels. And right now, data labels, I think, are set to none. Yep. And then I can choose where I want these, in the center, inside, outside, or best fit. I think I'm going to try center and see if that works for me. Okay, so I've got a few issues here, but let me go with this for a moment. They're in the center. All right, and let's see. I'm going to go to my series one over here. Oh, there it is, data labels. That's what I want. Now, my data labels also have a pretty small font size, so let's make those nice and big. How about a 20? And then I'm going to change their color, instead of gray, to white. Okay. Well, I'm kind of okay with this, but clearly these numbers are way too big, so they're all meshing together. So let me show you something that we can do to help clean this up, and that's something that the original chart did. So since all of these numbers are pretty large, I can look at my original source data and say, you know what? What if I was showing these in billions, 100,000, million, billion, because all of them are over a billion. So basically I could say, all right, I'm gonna take equals the original value and divide it by 1 million. That's gonna give me a much smaller, more manageable number there. And let's fill that down. That's pretty good, but you know what? I can divide by 1 billion So I'm going to take each of those values, divide it by a billion. That looks pretty good there. Okay, now I've got those values, but once again, my pie chart data needs to be all scrunched up next to each other in Excel 365. So I'm going to copy that data, go right over here, and then I'm going to select my old data, and then I'm going to go to my paste options, and I'm going to paste values. Put those right in there. So now basically I've changed how my original data looks for that pie chart. And I can see that my pie chart has already started to look a little bit better. Those numbers aren't nearly as scrunched up. Still, I might need to go back to my chart options, my data labels, and maybe I need to do best fit. And that makes those numbers a little bit easier to read. However, I should also correct my chart title so that everybody is clear that these values are in billions. I'll click OK, and there we go. So now it's a little bit easier to start to figure out, okay, so for the 24 and younger age group, which is the darker blue, that's a little tough. Darker blue, it's 115 billion versus the 35 to 49 year old group, which is $602 billion. So now we have a more simplified pie chart. But remember, simple data, really big fonts, as big as you can go. And in fact, that title could also be adjusted as well. And then you'll have a nice, easy to read pie chart. Thanks for hanging out with me.